Coventry Healthcare and Aetna Company proudly presents the 2014 Missouri Valley Conference Softball Tournament on Valley Live. From Marion Kinnear Stadium in Normal, Illinois, on the campus of Illinois State University, this is our fourth quarterfinal of the day as 7-seeded Loyola, fresh off a 4-0 victory over Drake earlier today, takes on the tournament's third seed, the Salukis of Southern Illinois. I'm R.C. McBride along with Laura Leonard, and Laura, looking at this matchup, promises to be another interesting one. We have seen some exciting softball thus far today, to say the least. What are your keys to this one?
Well, there's a couple of keys, and what Loyola needs to do is they need to ride the momentum. They've got the win of that first game in their first Missouri Valley Conference tournament. They need to continue with that momentum, and they need to continue to get strong pitching from Brittany Gardner. She had a really nice, solid game in that first game. They're putting her back in the circle today. We're going to see how much gas she has left in the tank. And then for Southern Illinois, talk about free pass. They have 259 free bases this season, either by walk or hit by pitch. They are very selective at the plate. They know how to get on base. And two base hits, what that means is they have a school record of 78 doubles this season. That ranks them 25th nationally. So they are gap hitters to help them score their runs.
Well, we're racing the weather a little bit to try to get this one in. We've been lucky so far. Stick around, our starting lineups and the first pitch of this one straight ahead as we continue on Valley Live.
You want affordable health care coverage that helps cover rising medical costs. And that's exactly what you'll get with Coventry. We offer a variety of affordable plans for you, your family, or business. To find out more, visit CoventryHealthcare.com today. Health, wellness, Coventry.
It's a star-struck summer at Casey's General Stores. Visit Casey's for spectacular spotlight savings, like Powerade 32-ounce bottles, 3 for $3, and large made-from-scratch taco pizzas for only $13.99. Plus, discover the secret word and enter to win a fabulous trip for two to Hollywood, $500 in gas, or other amazing prizes. Now premiering at Casey's General Stores. Casey's, famous for pizza.
Sorry.
Oh, hey, and check out that new look from Pepsi.
I don't know why, but today I feel a little bit different.
Oh, I feel like a woke this morning. I can change the world. I can change the world. I guess it's true.
You want affordable health care coverage that helps cover rising medical costs. And that's exactly what you'll get with Coventry. We offer a variety of affordable plans for you, your family, or business. To find out more, visit CoventryHealthcare.com today. Health, wellness, Coventry.
The 2014 Missouri Valley Conference Softball Tournament is brought to you by Coventry Healthcare and Aetna Company, the official presenting sponsor for the MVC-TV network. By Emerson, the global technology and engineering company. Emerson, consider it solved. And by Casey's General Store, Casey's, famous for pizza. Loyola and Southern Illinois set to go at it. Let's take a look at our starting lineup for Loyola. Presentation of Coventry Healthcare and Aetna Company. Visit CoventryHealthcare.com for more information. Health, wellness, Coventry Healthcare. And boy, did the Loyola lineup do its job. The top third of the order in the victory earlier over Drake. All three players, top three players, Bree Pasquale, Jessica Bolzano, and Lauren Moore with homers in that 4-0 win.
Boy, and Pasquale right off to start the ball game in that leadoff position. Knocks one out of the park to set the tone for Loyola and give them that 1-0 lead.
And our defense for Southern Illinois, we'll talk a little bit about who's going to be in the circle. It'll be Katie Bertelson. Bertelson, an all-Valley second-teamer, 14-12 on the year, 181 innings pitch, struck out 62. So she's not necessarily a fireballer or a traditional strikeout pitcher. She will occasionally have a little difficulty with the walk. 62 walks as well, so kind of an unusual 1-to-1 strikeout walk ratio.
Yeah, usually you see maybe a 2-to-1 strikeout to walk ratio, but she's right there 1-to-1, and she just needs to bear down, find the zone, let the defense work behind her. Go ahead, let them put it in play. You've got a pretty good infield behind you as well as a strong outfield.
Bertelson, a junior from Alexis, Illinois, Alexis United High School. And we'll get this one underway here shortly. We mentioned there are some showers and thunderstorms in the offing. We can work through the showers, not so much through the thunderstorms. So we're hoping we can get this one in. And brand new surface here at Marion Kinnear Stadium, so we won't worry too much about the overnight hours ahead of our semifinals tomorrow. The winner of this ball game will move on to play second seed Illinois State. Our other semifinal is already set. Bradley, the four seed, will play top seed Wichita State. You'd have to think Bradley is carrying some momentum into that ball game after its back and forth affair, an 8-5 victory to oust Missouri State immediately preceding this one.
Probably the most exciting game of the day because it was up and down and a lot of twists and turns within that ball game and momentum changes, and Bradley able to come out on top.
Bertelson in the circle and Bree Pasquale, the shortstop, who led off the game with a home run in the victory earlier over Drake, and the first pitch is low and in, and we are underway in our nightcap.
Well, and you know that Pasquale's in the batter's box just thinking, don't overswing, not thinking home run, just thinking, put it in play and get on base.
Pasquale with a couple of hits in that game. She's ahead on the count, 2-1. A storyline for Southern Illinois coming into this tournament, as it has been a storyline for several years, is for whatever reason, the Salukis have not been able to win this tournament. It's been 1991 since Southern Illinois has won a tournament championship. Now they've had regular season titles, they've been runner-up, they've been involved in the championship game, and they've had at-large NCAA berths, plenty of them. This is a storied program. Gary Blalock has done a fantastic job at the helm here, but for whatever reason, they've not been successful in this event. Ball has popped up, left center, and calling off. Parker is Glenn, one gone here in the first inning.
You can see how the wind played that ball. It started out center field, ends up over in left field. So get one up in the wind, it's going to move around a little bit on the defense.
Jessica Palzano steps in, and she rips one third baseway foul. He also had a home run, couple of RBI in the victory over Drake earlier.
And Kelsey Ashton over there at third base really hugging the line. And we saw that Balzano last time pitched before this really turned and ripped one down the third baseline.
Add another foul. Hope everybody's paying attention in the dugout.
Yeah, I have to. You got to be on your toes. You can't be thinking about anything else. Can't be daydreaming in those dugouts.
One-two pitch in the dirt, 2-2. Balzano batting .285 on the year, three homers, including the one earlier today, 20 driven in. Bertelsen fires low, so Valzano works the count full.
Bertelsen has certainly thrown the most amount of innings for this Saluki team, and so they go with her to start this ball game, and she gets deep into the counts, but she's gotten two outs.
Soft liner to Gonzalez at short for the second out. This will bring up Moore and Moore. Moore also homered against Drake. Hers was kind of the icing on the cake.
Yeah, it really was, and all of them stung, but the last one was the one that really cemented the deal for Loyola.
Oh, one, and this one well hit deep left field. It is gone. Oh. Lauren Moore's second home run of the day. And Loyola takes a 1-0 lead.
Well, they started out their first game. However, it was Pasquale who knocked the home run out of the park to give them the one-run lead. Lauren Moore gets a pitch that she can handle, steps right into it, and drives it. The wind was pushing it, but she started it out far enough that it didn't push it into foul territory. It stayed fair.
Wind blowing from right to left field, as it has pretty much all day. You're right, that ball was probably hit to straightaway left field when it left the bat, kept curving, and just did stay fair. So, for the second time today, Brittany Gardner, the Valley Pitcher of the Year, will go to the circle with the lead.
Well, and the way she worked in that first game, she did a really nice job of keeping the Bulldog hitters off balance.
Taryn Schaefer, the catcher and cleanup hitter, stands in against Bertelsen. And the pitch. Swing and a miss, 0-2.
The way Bertelsen's coming back strong after giving up the home run, going right after the next hitter in Schaefer.
And the pitch, a wave and a miss. First strikeout for Bertelsen, but Lauren Moore puts Loyola on top, a solo home run. We head to the bottom of the first inning. Loyola 1, Southern Illinois coming up.
Yeah, I'm married. Doesn't matter. You do that for me? Really? Yeah, I'd like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's Jake from State Farm. Sounds like a really good deal.
Jake from State Farm at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's Jake from State Farm.
What are you wearing, Jake from State Farm?
Khakis.
She sounds hideous.
Well, she's a guy, so.
Another reason more people stay with State Farm. Get to a better state.
Grind virtually any kind of food waste into an unending source of electrical power for a city? When Emerson takes up the challenge, it's never been done before, simply becomes, consider it solved. Emerson.
Bottom of the first inning, Southern Illinois coming to the plate for the first time. Let's take a look at the Saluki starting lineup, a presentation of Coventry Healthcare and Aetna Company. Visit CoventryHealthcare.com for more information. Health, wellness, Coventry Healthcare, and a nice mix of experience and some younger players on this team. Jana Spivey, an all-Valley first-teamer. She's one of those players that it just kind of seems as though she's in her seventh or eighth year, but she has really been an outstanding player for this program. Now the Loyola defense behind pitcher Brittany Gardner, a presentation of Casey's General Store, Casey's, famous for pizza.
They did a nice job in that first ball game behind Gardner, and Gardner did most of the heavy lifting, working that strike zone, being very efficient, but her defense picked it up behind her. See those 7 strikeouts earlier today.
Yeah, nice win for Gardner. Going the distance. Struck out 9. Walked a pair, giving up 4 hits. And I'm not sure that was... she was necessarily at her best.
Yeah, I don't know. There were a couple of innings where she did struggle a little bit, but for the most part, able to get around it and come away with the win.
Standing in is the center fielder, Kaylin Harker, a 312 hitter, batting 457 when she leads off an inning.
That's why you have her in the top spot. That's why you have her leading off. Good eye, very patient at the plate, has some speed, able to put it in play. A lot of times hitters like that just like to make contact so they can turn and run.
Harker, a junior from Lebanon, Indiana, and she's ahead on the count, 2-0. Swung on and missed. So Gardner bounces back. Saluki swept Loyola earlier this year. Get a real sense from that center field shot just how windy it's getting.
Yeah, thought it was dying down just a little bit, but it certainly has picked up, and the flags are, you can see, really whipping in that wind.
And ball 4. So Harker gets on to try to get things going for the Salukis, and that'll bring Kelsey Ashton, the third baseman, to the plate. Loyola striking first, a solo homer for Lauren Moore, her second of the day, and her team leading 9th on the year. It came in the top of this inning. So the Salukis trying to answer. Ashton, a 216 hitter. And we look for her to bunt here. She does square, takes the ball.
You've seen all the coaches play it in a variety of ways when you get that leadoff runner on. We've seen coaches go ahead and play it by the book, move the runner down to second base. We've seen the coaches where they're hitting away and not moving that runner. So a lot of different schools of thought.
Lays this one down. Throw to first is in time. Successful sacrifice for Ashton. As Harker moves to second, Ashton is the team leader in sacrifice bunts. Executes perfectly there for the heart of the order now, Spivey.
Well, when you have somebody that gets on base at the clip, as far as a leadoff, as far as Harker, you are the number 2 batter behind her is definitely going to be the leader in sacrifices because you do have somebody on in front of you more often than not.
Jana Spivey, an All-Missouri Valley Conference first-team selection, a senior. And the change just misses outside.
Now, Spivey really has had a great career, and you're right, she is. I was thinking about that as I was coming over to the tournament and thinking about some of the players that we've seen throughout the years, and Spivey's name came to the top, and I thought, boy, she's still around, and it's exactly what you said. She's made such an impact. And players like that always stick in the front of your mind, and that's how she's been so good, is her defense out in the field and what she does at the plate. People remember her.
1-1 pitch on the way. Swing and a miss by Spivey. Should mention our umpires for this evening's game. Chad Spittler behind the plate. Aaron Eller at first and Sally Keller at third. So Spivey behind on the count, 1-2. Runner in scoring position is Harker. And the 1-2 sailed on her.
It did, and she had a little extra power behind that one. We saw multiple speeds from Gardner in that first game. We saw slower, and then we saw that ball dance around as it got to the plate and with a little speed behind it.
2-2 pitch. And a big strikeout for Brittany Gardner. She has that little thing she goes through after
And that's not always just a strikeout. It could be a big out.
It could be a big play. And they get the out, and she turns around, and she looks at the center fielder, and you will see that they mimic each other's actions for the most part. And so, again, the other thing I like about Gardner, she looks at her catcher after a big strikeout and points to her, and, like, good teamwork, way to go, good call, and that's why they work so well together.
Shea Hari, the designated player, stands in. Shea is a freshman from Nashville, Illinois. 2-0. Hari, a 336 average, an All-Valley team member as a freshman, 5 homers, 43 driven in. And the 2-0 on the way. Strike. We talked about this in the game earlier. We're fortunate enough, Laura and I, to be able to... We're sitting right behind home plate. Actually, we're right behind the score badge there. And the movement that you see from Gardner is impressive. That one is booted by Pasquale. It's in the center field, and a run will score.
Sometimes when you have a runner that goes in front of you going second to third, you take your eye off the grounder. And Pasquale had a beat on that grounder. But the runner runs right in front of her, blocks her a little bit, and she couldn't pick it clean. That allows the run to come home. Harker scores off the air.
Well, I think you have to give Harker a lot of credit. You saw it on that replay. She hesitated at just the right time. It was done deliberately, and it worked. And SIU has tied the game at 1 with 2 outs. Runner at first, Kelsey Gonzalez, the shortstop, stands in against Gardner. Gonzalez batting 326 on the year. She has some pop with 4 homers and 22 driven in. And the 1-0. 2-0.
No, that's exactly what you want from your team. If Coach Kerry Blaylock bounced right back after getting down 1-0 in the top of the inning, able to earn that run back and tie it back up.
But just to finish the point I was making before the error, we were fortunate enough to sit right behind home plate, and it's a different look with Gardner being a left-hander, but the movement on her pitches is really something to see.
Yeah, the ball would it start out on the outside and it tail in or out, or vice versa, it'd start out inside and move out over the plate. There were times where it even looked like it might be a knuckleball. It just kind of rattled up there to the plate, and the hitters could not catch up to it.
Fouled straight back by Gonzalez. Lights have been turned on. You can see the reflection in Gonzalez's helmet there. Two on the way. Tried to hit that outside corner.
They were working that the entire game against the Bulldogs, and they were getting that call. That one was a little too far off the plate, but that's just how these two work, Schaefer and Gardner. They know exactly, they're on the same page. They work very well together.
Runner will be going. 3-2 pitch, fouled away. So Gonzalez will try it again, and back to first goes Hari. Three, two. Ball four. Second walk of the inning for Gardner. And Taylor Orsburn, the first baseman, will stand in. Runners at first and second, Gonzalez and Hari, respectively. And a meeting of the battery as Schaefer heads out to talk to Gardner.
Now a little bit longer meeting in the circle, a little bit discussion, and we talked a little bit about this in the first game. When Gardner had runners on base, she changed her approach to the hitters at the plate. And so now she's in a situation, she's given up the tying run, you have another runner in scoring position, and two down, so it's early on, but I think it's a big situation here for Loyola being the lower seed.
Well, this at bat, the outcome of this will determine who has the momentum.
Yeah, because if you get the out here, the momentum comes back to the Loyola dugout. If you get the base hit, oh, it moves right over to the Salukis dugout.
Taylor Orsburn looks at ball one. Orsburn batting 262, 5 homers, 30 driven in on the season, so she is a dangerous hitter. Now the 1-0. It's the outside corner. You mentioned it earlier, but that is something that Gardner and Schaefer really work together to do, is try to find out exactly where that corner is for each individual hitter.
And sometimes you'll see Schaefer move
off the end of the bat. Throw to first is in time. So an unearned run scored by the Salukis. We are through one, tied at one, here on Valley Live.
Word is getting out. Purina Dog Chow Light and Healthy is a deliciously tender and crunchy kibble blend with 20% fewer calories than Purina Dog Chow. Isn't it time you discovered the lighter side of Dog Chow? Purina Dog Chow Light and Healthy.
The online store at mvcgear.com is the number one stop to get Missouri Valley Conference merchandise. With thousands of items, you'll find all the MVC gear you need in one place. You'll find the best selection, great customer service, and secure order processing. You'll also get an easy and enjoyable experience designed to help you find exactly what you're looking for. So if you want the best place to get Missouri Valley Conference gear, head to the online store at mvcgear.com.
Who could resist the call of America's number one puppy food brand? With DHA and essential nutrients also found in mother's milk. Purina Puppy Chow.
To the top of the second we go, tied at one, and be sure to catch our next game coming up at noon Central tomorrow as top seed and NBC regular season champion Wichita State takes on fourth-seeded Bradley here at Marion Kinnear Stadium. The contest will be followed by our second semifinal at 2:30 Central, which will feature second-seed Illinois State and the winner of this game right here on Valley Live. Katie Bertelson for the Salukis into her second inning of work. She will face 5, 6, and 7 in the Loyola order. Bertelson delivers a strike to Olivia Bell. Bell 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts. She's a senior from Plainfield, Illinois. 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts in the game earlier, the victory over Drake.
You can,
that went well off the plate.
You can certainly see the way the wind is blowing. Not only the flags, but you can see other things, that the players' hair, the ponytails are whipping in the wind.
Liner to short, caught by Gonzalez. So Bell off the end of the bat, making a bid for a base hit, but it was right at Gonzalez, and this will bring Annie Court, the left fielder, to the plate.
Bertelson with a loose shoelace and having to get that fixed.
Misses 1-0. Gorth batting 250. A homer, 6 driven in on the year. Chops it foul.
And I know you don't ever want to hurry things up, but knowing that there is some impending weather, I think as a coach you talk to your team about that and say, let's be a little mindful of what the situation is and see if we can work a little bit quicker. I know you have to keep your strategy and your philosophy, what you're going to do with each hitter. But you also have to know that you want to get this ball game in because you don't want to get into a couple innings and have to come back and finish it. We've done that a couple of times in the conference tournament where you've gotten the game started and then had to come back the next day and play three innings.
Popped up, out of play. Well, and one thing to keep in mind, you know, again, it's tied. We're in the second inning, so it's still very early in this one, but we were speaking with some folks from Southern Illinois prior to the start of this one, and, you know, the thought, now this wasn't the team. You know, this is not somebody who sits in the dugout, but it is somebody associated with the program, and their comment was, you know, let's get this in. I don't really want to give Gardner a night's sleep to think about it and come back out rested tomorrow. Off the end of the bat, nice pick at second by Spivey. Two gone.
Good hands by Spivey, and that's why everybody knows her and recognizes what she can do out in the field. She's got great hands, has great range, and I would agree with the Southern Illinois insider. You don't want to give another day's rest to Gardner.
Well, neither of these teams wants to bounce back. One of these teams is going to move on to play Illinois State. So if, you know, the rain comes, and when the rain does come, I have the feeling it's going to be here for a while. So you really don't want to turn that advantage over to Illinois State. Come in completely fresh in that second semifinal tomorrow.
A lot of factors play into this ball game.
Swing and a miss by Zaworski. 1-2. Zaworski, the right fielder, a senior from Palatine, Illinois, and Fremd High School. The 1-2, swing and a miss. Second strikeout for Bertelson. 1-2-3, go the Ramblers in the second inning. To the bottom of the second we go. Game tied at 1.
Watch your Cardinals take the field from a whole new perspective this season. Introducing the AT&T Rooftop, located on the deck of Cardinals Nation at the new Ballpark Village. It's a unique way to enjoy a game in style. The AT&T Rooftop features more than 300 outdoor seats overlooking Busch Stadium, with amenities like an upscale buffet, a full-service bar, an exclusive indoor club, as well as complimentary admission to the Cardinals Hall of Fame and Museum. Visit Cardinals.com and get your AT&T Rooftop tickets today.
To laugh, and when the sun is out, I've got something I can laugh about.
Wherever you've been, whatever you've been through, we've got a warm welcome waiting for you. And that is only the beginning. DoubleTree by Hilton, where the little things mean everything.
Bottom of the second inning, game tied at a run apiece, and this evening's Missouri Valley Conference Scholar Athlete of the Game is Southern Illinois' Gina Spivey, a senior infielder from Rose Claire, Illinois. Spivey's batting at .346 with 17 doubles, a triple, 5 homers, and 36 RBIs. Spivey has a 3.761 GPA in biological science, is a 3-time All-MVC selection, 2-time first-team MVC Scholar Athlete choice, and 2-time COSIDA Academic All-District honoree. So as we said, she's done a lot of everything.
Yeah, not just on the field. He's done it in the classroom as well.
Spivey's 17 doubles, by the way, are a single season record for the program and puts her 19th in the nation coming into this weekend.
This team 25th nationally as far as team doubles, 78 on the season.
The catcher, Allie Vadbunker, steps in to face Gardner. Inside, strike one. That's an impossible strike to hit.
Yeah, in under the hands, inside part of the plate, you just can't do anything unless you step back in the box. Then you can't cover the outside part of the plate.
Schaefer trying to frame that one, nothing doing. Count even at a ball and a strike. Bad bunker batting 233. Well, she's hitting 583 when leading off an inning. 1-1 pitch.
They've got some players on this team that do a good job, know what their role is. What doesn't matter where they are in the lineup, it's when they get up in an inning, and if they're the leadoff, they do a good job of setting the table, getting on base.
Fouled away. Bad bunker stays alive. That is an area where sometimes the basic stats don't tell the full story, because situational hitting and mental adjustments to those situations do make a difference.
Yeah, you just have to know if you have runners on base, am I moving the runner, should I hit to the right side, should I hit to the left side, or am I just leading off the inning and am I going to just try to get myself on somehow, some way? And some players take a look at the defense, even if they're a power hitter, and may try to lay one down to get on base.
And it hangs in the air. Bell ranges over to make the catch. One gone in the bottom of the second as Bad Bunker flies to Bell. Now right fielder Mary Ann Patterson.
Now batting for Southern Illinois, number one, Mary Ann Patterson.
She's a 283 hitter, a 400 on base percentage. I always figure anytime your on base percentage is 70, 80, 90 points higher than your batting average, you're doing a pretty good job. When you're at almost 120 points higher, you're a pretty disciplined hitter.
Well, yeah, you get on however you can get yourself on, and whether it's via the walk or hit by pitch or just putting the ball in play and getting on base that way. That's a huge accomplishment. You just want, doesn't matter how you get there, just get on base. And I know that's what coaches want. Don't care how you get there, just get on base so we can move you around and we can put a little strategy into it.
She's ahead on the count. Now 3-0. Rio pitch. Strike.
It's usually automatic, it seems like. 3-0 pitch.
That pitch just drills right inside on the hands of a right-handed hitter. 3-1. Strike two on the outside corner.
Patterson already two or three steps down towards first base after that. Thought she had been able to get the walk, but has to step back in with a full count now. A little extra discussion.
So Gardner with the 3-2. That's a nice play at short, and the wild throw into the dugout. So Patterson will advance to second. That will likely go as a single and an error.
Pasquale had to cover a lot of ground and get up the middle, try to right herself and make a throw, and the ball sailed on her and went into the dugout.
It would have been a bang-bang play had the throw been perfect.
Pasquale did a great job of covering, getting up the middle, and even getting a glove on that ball.
So it is a single and an error. So a single and an error is the official ruling from the official scorer. Do official scorers make any non-official rulings?
No. Thus the title.
Michelle Glenn stands in. She's ahead of the count. 2-0.
You can see the cards that the players have on their forearms. They get the signal from the coach and they look at their armbands and know exactly what they're supposed to do.
3-0 now the count to Glenn. Admit it, you've thought about getting those for day-to-day life.
Oh.
The wrist, yeah. The wristbands with
absolutely.
The flip open.
Yes. And, well, I think they'd come in very handy if you want somebody, you know, maybe you don't want to say something to somebody and just want to give them a signal.
Right.
Just go, hey, look at number 4 on your wrist.
Or maybe just to help you remember things. Uh-huh. Glenn draws a walk.
That's what sticky notes are for.
Okay. You want to put some equations or something there.
Now batting for the Salukis, number 12.
What if everybody in the world just wore those?
Well, that would momentarily distract us all from our phones.
Which might not be a bad thing.
So Southern Illinois trying to get a one-out rally going here. We go to the top of the order. Kaylin Harker, she walked her first time up, came around to score the Saluki run, and she looks at a strike. So Glenn is your runner at first, Patterson at second. Gardner trying to work her way out of a one-out jam here. And the 0-1, swing and a miss. Schaefer came out of there as though she was going to throw behind someone.
She was going to gun somebody down. You don't want to venture too far off the base. But your infielders have to know that you're ready to fire at any time, so they need to be over covering.
The 0-2 is outside. Harker not chasing. So the 1-2 swung on, well hit, deep left field. Going back to get it is Korth. The runner's going to try to advance. Play, throw is not in time. Patterson with a risky effort to advance from second to third on the fly ball. The runner at first, Glenn, did not advance.
Patterson tags up. She can see, got back. Tagged the bag, got in head first, very close though.
Yeah, that throw is waist high or lower. I think she's out.
Yeah, if it's right at the bag, you have her. A great job, of course, going back on that ball right at the fence. She hauls it in and then makes the throw, and a strong throw because she really couldn't get a whole lot of momentum behind it. She had to throw right away.
Runner going from first, and it'll be a stolen base for Glenn. So two runners in scoring position. Glenn 16 for 16 on the season in stolen base attempts. And the pitch off the end of the bat, foul. So Ashton with a chance to do some real damage here. Two outs. Count even at a ball and a strike. And the pitch to Ashton. 2-1.
Now Gardner laboring a little bit. Can't seem to find that groove that she had in that first ball game. Big situation here. Does not want to give up the base hit because that would mean two runs.
2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. So Gardner trying to pitch her way out of it. Three walks for Gardner in the game. She's given up 107 on the season in just over 203 innings pitched. Here's a big 2-2. Swing and a grounder. Picked up nicely at short. Throw is in time. Pasquale had that one eat her up a little bit. But a nice play to get the runner, and Southern Illinois strands two in the second. Through two, game tied at a run apiece.
In the insurance business, you think differently about a customer when you stand in the middle of his dreams. When she serves you breakfast every Saturday morning. When his son plays on the same team as your son. When you live down the street from your customers, you make sure they get covered right. And you make sure you're there when they need you. That's the way it's done around here. Grinnell Mutual, a policy of working together. To find a Grinnell Mutual agent near you, go to grinnellmutual.com.
Title game of the Missouri Valley Conference Softball Tournament comes your way Saturday. The winner receives the league's automatic bid to the NCAA Tournament. Remember, that game will not be available here on Valley Live. Coverage begins Saturday at 2:30 Central on Fox Sports Midwest, Fox Sports Indiana, Fox Sports Kansas City, Fox College Sports, Comcast Sportsnet Chicago, and ESPN3. Check your channel guide for more information. A nice backhand stab by Gina Spivey. Retires Jacqueline Murphy.
Great range by Spivey going up the middle, backhands that ball.
Now batting for the Ramblers, number 16.
Just shows you she can go left or right. She just does a great job of covering the ground balls, moving up the middle, closing down that gap. And if you look at the infield right now, it looks like there's a big gap up the middle, but with Gonzalez and Spivey right in the middle part of the infield, they can cover a lot of ground.
Nice stab by Bertelson to rob Katie LaCivita of a base hit. So a couple of pretty hard hit balls here in the third inning. Not much to show for it for the Ramblers.
Good quick reaction time. Get the glove down in a hurry. And you're right. Two batters, two very well hit balls, but the defense outstanding for the Salukis.
Bree Pasquale stands in, lifts this one to right field. Patterson went back, then came in to make the catch. So Loyola goes down 1-2-3. We're through 2.5. Game still tied at one.
You could fly to Venice or Paris. Copenhagen. You could fly all over the world. But why? When you could just come to St. Louis. Your trip begins at ExploreSt.Louis.com.
The administrators, educators, coaches, and fans of the Missouri Valley Conference expect nothing but the best from their teams. And the Valley student athletes take pride in exceeding that expectation. On the field, on the court, on the track, and in the classroom. Celebrating academic and athletic excellence for more than 100 years, this is the Missouri Valley Conference.
Missouri Valley Conference regular season standings, a presentation of Purina Dog Chow. Help keep him strong, Dog Chow strong. Wichita State and Illinois State will see their first action tomorrow at 12 and 2:30 respectively. Wichita State will take on 4-seed Bradley. And Southern Illinois trying to advance past 7-seed Loyola to take on Illinois State. If Southern Illinois can pull this one out, we'd find ourselves, I'm sure that somebody will be on top of this, but I don't think we've had too many occasions where the top 4 seeds were the final 4 seeds left in this tournament.
No, I can't think of a tournament in recent years where 1, 2, 3, 4 advanced.
There's always somebody making the upset bid, and Loyola The last team with an opportunity to do that. Dana Spivey stands in. Grounder to first. Murphy takes it unassisted. One gone in the third.
Now batting for the Salukis, number 25, Jay Hari.
Jay Hari stands in. Hari reached on an error in the first inning. That error by Pasquale allowed Harker to score.
There again, starts her off with a pitch that you just can't handle. I mean, just there's, you know it's coming, you just can't pull the trigger on it. It's right on a part of the plate where you can't get those arms extended.
Down even now to ball and a strike. Change up, tough to hit.
Very tough to hit. I didn't think the umpire was going to call that. I thought, oh my Lord, that got a big part of the plate and it was right there in the zone. He was just a little slow on the call, but that was a perfect pitch.
And now the 1-2. Missed outside.
Now Gardner was asked after that first ball game if being named Pitcher of the Year had any effect on the game or the way she approached the game, and she said, you know, no, not really. She goes, it's a great award, but you know what, this is certainly a team effort and what we're trying to do. We're a team, and we won as a team, and it wasn't any one person.
So the strikeout by Hari brings Gonzalez to the plate. Off the hands, still to deep left field, going back and making the catch at the wall was Korth. So Gonzalez gave it a ride, but 1-2-3 go the Salukis in the third. We are through three. Game still tied at one.
It's a star-struck summer at Casey's General Stores. Visit Casey's for spectacular spotlight savings, like Powerade 32-ounce bottles, 3 for $3, and large made-from-scratch taco pizzas for only $13.99. Plus, discover the secret word and enter to win a fabulous trip for two to Hollywood, $500 in gas or other amazing prizes. Now premiering at Casey's General Stores. Casey's, famous for pizza.
Life has its twists and turns. It can take many different shapes. But a good retirement plan changes with your life. And as we talk about what you're putting away and how much you'll need to retire, what was uncertain becomes clear. At Wells Fargo Advisors, we believe conversation leads to financial clarity. Let's start a conversation today.
Our game recap, a presentation of the DoubleTree by Hilton, the official hotel of the Missouri Valley Conference in Bloomington Normal. Call 309-664-6446 or visit DoubleTree.com to book your hotel rooms on your next trip to Central Illinois. So Moore had the home run for Loyola. That was the game's first run, and the error by the shortstop Pasquale led to the Saluki run, and that's where we are right now.
You can see right there on that scorecard, just the one colored in, and that's where we are. One run apiece. One diamond colored in on each side of the scorecard.
Jessica Balzano and against Katie Bertelson. Bertelson, three innings pitched. The one hit, the home run, she struck out two, no walks.
Other than that home run, she's been very good.
We mentioned at the outset, she's not a big strikeout pitcher. Tends to try to put the ball in play. and let her defense do the work.
Yeah, she's gotten some balls that have been hit fairly hard. She's gotten some line outs, a couple of ground balls, mainly pop-ups, though. But she's letting her defense do the work behind her.
2-2 pitch on the way. Laced off the glove of Ashton down the line, and this is going to be a double. Malzano with a leadoff double. And the dangerous Lauren Moore coming to the plate.
That was a shot. Balzano was able to turn on that, keep it in the field of play, shows the bat, and then drills it right off the glove of Ashton down into the corner.
Ashton with a great effort, just not quite tall enough, not quite quick enough. That was a hard hit ball down the line. And Moore homered her last trip to the plate. She has two homers today, having hit one against Drake in the earlier game.
See how they pitch to her. You have to believe that they're going to be very careful and very selective about where they place these pitches.
9 home runs on the season.
It's like we've got somebody warming up in the Loyola bullpen. Just in case.
Pitches outside 3-0. I can't imagine. Bertelsen's going to give her much to hit here.
I would be shocked if she came in even close to the plate.
4-pitch walk. First base on balls given by Bertelsen, and Perry Blalock is going to come out for a huddle.
Got to talk strategy here. Now you have a force at any base, and that's exactly what they're going to talk about. What do you need to do if the ball comes to you? How are you going to pitch to Schaefer? And it's a short meeting in the circle, but you just have to talk strategy and know what you're going to do if the ball comes to you, because more often than not, the ball does go into play when Bertelsen is pitching.
So runners at first and second. Terrence Schaefer stands in, batting 259. Hitting 315 with runners on this season. She has 3 home runs. She bunts and bunts up the line. Ashton throws to first in time. Both runners advance, so a sacrifice for Schaefer. Ashton not taking any chances. You should take a look. This ball might have rolled foul, but she had it in front of her and took the out.
Well, you hate to. That ball could have gone either way. You know, hit a rock, stay fair, could have gone foul. And if you have the play right there in front of you and she's got the good strong arm, go ahead and get the out, even though it does advance the runners.
Olivia Bell, batting 245 on the year, stands in with two runners in scoring position, and she is quickly behind on the count 0-2.
You got to be smart base runners here. Make sure line drive, any line drive, gets through the infield before you take off too far from the base. You don't want to get doubled up in this situation.
One and two, the count to Bell. Swung on, and that's going to drive in a pair. Bell on her way to second, pulls up there as both Balzano and Moore score. A 2-RBI double for Olivia Bell puts Loyola up 3-1.
Ball kind of hung up and out over the plate. She hung back just enough to be able to get the fat part of the bat on it, find the gap, and score two runs.
So Loyola takes a 3-1 lead. Still a runner in scoring position, and still just one out. Annie Korth fouls it away. 0-2.
Annie Korth has had a really good day in the outfield. She's made some spectacular plays. Balls that are hit right out to the fence. Done a good job of defending those, getting back to the wall, getting the hand on the fence, hauling them in. She's done it defensively, looking with this opportunity to add another run and do it offensively for a team.
One, two pitch, a little bit low. Wind really picking up now. Still blowing right to left. Two, two, strike, three, call. And that is a big get for Bertelsen. Two gone.
Needed the strikeout at that point in time, and she places it right in a spot that's very tough to go out and get.
Three Ks for Bertelsen. Lauren Zaworski stands in. Runner at second is Bell. She had the two-run double. It's a 3-1 lead for the Ramblers. Loyola, the seventh seed, knocked off sixth seed Drake 4-0 earlier today. Trying to beat the tournament's three seed, Southern Illinois.
A lot of getting these runs is timing and getting those runners in place. We saw a game earlier where all it took was one base hit and then everybody was contagious. Everybody up and down the lineup for Bradley started hitting the ball.
Zaworski beyond the count 0-2. Bell still at second base after the double. Bertelsen's 0-2. Well, that looked better than the last called strike.
Yeah, it sure did. I think Bertelsen thought she had it. She turned and walked away, thought she had the strikeout, but has to step back into the circle.
The 1-2. Squibbed back to her, and Bertelsen throws it to first. But Olivia Bell, with a two-run double, puts Loyola on top. We're halfway through. Loyola leading Southern Illinois 3-1.
Word is getting out. Purina Dog Chow Light and Healthy is a deliciously tender and crunchy kibble blend with 20% fewer calories than Purina Dog Chow. Isn't it time you discovered the lighter side of Dog Chow? Purina Dog Chow Light and Healthy.
Watch your Cardinals take the field from a whole new perspective this season. Introducing the AT&T Rooftop, located on the deck of Cardinals Nation at the new Ballpark Village. It's a unique way to enjoy a game in style. The AT&T Rooftop features more than 300 outdoor seats overlooking Busch Stadium, with amenities like an upscale buffet, a full-service bar, an exclusive indoor club, as well as complimentary admission to the Cardinals Hall of Fame and Museum. Visit Cardinals.com and get your AT&T Rooftop tickets today.
Who could resist the call of America's number one puppy food brand? With DHA and essential nutrients also found in mother's milk. Purina Puppy Chow.
Head to the bottom of the fourth. 3-1 Loyola on top. So the pitcher of the year, working with a two-run lead, trying to pilot her team into tomorrow's semifinal matchup.
Now Southern Illinois got down early in the top half of the first inning. They were able to bounce back. They answered in the bottom half of the inning. Going to have to do the same here. They've given up two runs in the top half of this inning. They need to respond.
Salukis have some hitters, however. Change up from Gardner to Taylor Orsburn in for a strike.
See the smile on Orsburn's face. She knew she had a pitch to hit right there. Could have driven that ball to the outfield. Just could not get herself to make the stride in the swing.
That is the beauty of the changeup, right? It throws off your entire timing.
Keeps you guessing, keeps you off balance, and then you have to wonder, are they going to come back with it again? So then that even plays with the hitter's mind a little bit more.
Strike two.
A little excitement behind the plate. Schaefer, a little fist pump with that call. They set up nicely, able to get the outside part of the plate.
And the 1-2. Orsburn stays alive. The 1-2, swing and a miss.
That was in on the hands. The great pitch. Big cut by Orsburn. Just had no chance to even get a piece of that ball.
So your son or daughter, or little kid, asks you what it means to handcuff a hitter. Show them that replay.
Yeah. No way that any hitter, I don't care who you are, can catch up with that one.
Change up to Allie Vadbunker, misses outside for a ball. Three strikeouts for Gardner. One gone in the fourth. And the pitch off the end of the bat. Vadbunker hitting 231, three homers, 16 driven in.
Schaefer always lobbying to try to get that call. She does pretty much every pitch, just holds it there just for that split second, let the umpire get another good look at it. Not that they're going to get that call. The umpire's going to call it when it comes over the plate.
This one is well struck to center field, but it stays in the park. Bell makes the catch with a little room to spare.
Now batting for Southern Illinois, number one.
Boy, I thought she got all of that, the way it sounded coming off the bat.
It did, didn't it?
But it just hung up there enough for Bell to get over and glove it.
And the wind, more of a crosswind as opposed to a wind blowing straight out, may have contributed to that ball staying in the park. It did sound good off the bat. Two gone in the bottom of the fourth for Mary Ann Patterson. She singled in the second. And the pitch. So now we're even.
Southern Illinois trying to be selective at the plate, knowing they have a few innings to try to get back these two runs.
Off the hands, out to get it. Nice play by the catcher, Schaefer. So, 1-2-3 go the Salukis. Gardner's retired 8 in a row. We're through 4. Loyola leads 3-1.
You want affordable health care coverage that helps cover rising medical costs, and that's exactly what you'll get with Coventry. We offer a variety of affordable plans for you, your family, or business. To find out more, visit CoventryHealthcare.com today. Health, wellness, Coventry.
Only the best music.
Here is a track from Out of Sight.
Sorry.
Oh, hey, and check out that new look from Pepsi.
I don't know why, but today I feel a little bit different.
Oh. I feel like I woke up this morning and I can change the world. I can change the world. I guess it's true.
You want affordable health care coverage that helps cover rising medical costs, and that's exactly what you'll get with Coventry. We offer a variety of affordable plans for you, your family, or business. To find out more, visit CoventryHealthcare.com today. Health, wellness, Coventry.
Loyola with a two-run lead here in the top of the fifth inning. And let's take a look at our series history. A production of the DoubleTree by Hilton, the official hotel of the Missouri Valley Conference in Bloomington-Normal. Call 309-664-6446. or visit Doubletree.com to book your hotel rooms on your next trip to Central Illinois. So you saw on the series history that the Salukis lead the series all time 5-0. Loyola, a newcomer to the Missouri Valley Conference after years in the Horizon League. So they haven't had a lot of occasion to play one another, but Loyola looking for its first ever victory over the Salukis. And for the Ramblers, that would come at a fantastic time in a do-or-die situation.
Well, they would like to make some noise in their first Missouri Valley Conference tournament and see if they can get themselves to the semifinals with an opportunity to get to that final game.
Tough hop. Gonzalez throws out Murphy. One gone in the fifth.
It was a tough hop right up into her, but stayed with it. Got those hands up there, able to field it cleanly and make a good strong throw.
Katie Bertelson delivers. Katie LaCivita pops it up on the infield. Gonzalez there to get it. Two gone.
Reaching out for that pitch out over the plate. Got too far underneath it. Tried to pull it. Popped it straight up.
Does it look to you as though Loyola is being more deliberately aggressive in the batter's box?
Well, I think they are. I think they know that they can come out and attack. If they get runners on base, good things have happened for them. And you have to figure once you get on base, that slows things down. Bertelson starts thinking about the runners, throws her timing off a little bit. So the more aggressive you are, the more you can get on base, the more you're going to get into the pitcher's head.
1-1 pitch. A changeup to shortstop Bree Pasquale. 0-2 in this game, but a home run against Drake earlier today. Skied to center. Harker camping makes the catch. And Loyola goes down 1-2-3 through 4.5. The Ramblers leading the Salukis 3-1.
Have you tried one of these? It's so good.
Man, I can't believe we haven't done this before.
Oh, wow, look at that.
On a bike.
You're aging. Do the jingle. Do the jingle.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, guys.
Do it again. Do it again.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
In my office.
State Farm.
I think we're good.
State Farm agents help you get to a better state.
Sure to catch our next game coming at noon Central tomorrow as top seed and MVC regular season champion Wichita State takes on four-seeded Bradley here at Marion Kinnear Stadium. That contest will be followed by our second semifinal at 2:30 Central between second-seed Illinois State and the winner of this game. We'll catch them both right here on Valley Live. Bottom of the fifth inning and the third-seed Salukis trailing and starting to run out of outs. And the Valley Pitcher of the Year, Brittany Gardner, cruising, having now retired 8 Salukis in a row. Gardner has had an outstanding career at Loyola. 3-time All-Horizon League selection before her program joined the Valley, and comes over, wins Pitcher of the Year honors this year. Michelle Glenn, the ninth place hitter, drew a walk. Her only previous trip. Trying the bunt. Just trying to get something going.
I like that. I like the aggressive nature to just put the ball in play to see if you can get that leadoff runner on.
Glenn was the last Saluki to reach base. Pulled back before offering.
Infield pulled in a little bit. Now Moore backs up a little bit to play even with the bag. But she charges hard. Once she sees that bat move and those hands move, she's charging.
One and two. Mary Blaylock going to have a conversation with the home plate umpire. It's a relatively short one.
Yeah, I don't think she was happy with the call that Glenn offered at that pitch. Thought she might have pulled it back.
I thought she did too, but 1-2, 2-2. But in the end, it doesn't really matter what anybody else thinks other than the guy wearing the light blue shirt.
The blue shirt. They're in charge.
2-2 pitch. Bunted. Throw to first is in time. Moore got in on that ball in a hurry.
She does such a great job anticipating and charging from that third base position. Plays about even with the bag, starts creeping in as the pitch comes, gets right on it, and then throws a rocket over to first base.
Good quick release, too. 9 straight Salukis retired by Gardner as we head to the top of the order. And Kaylin Harker. And she shows bunt. Gardner spins, not in time.
I think that surprised everybody. And she disguised that, held back, didn't move the hands. The last minute she got the bat down, laid it down perfectly, and hustled down to first base. Get the coverage over there. Melzano a little late getting over, but that ball was so well placed. I'm not sure even if Melzano would have gotten there, they would have gotten her.
With that placement, a right-handed pitcher might have had a shot, but Gardner had to pirouette before the throw, and no way she was going to get it there in time. So a bunt single for Harker. This brings Ashton to the plate, representing the tying run here in the fifth inning. And she looks at a strike on the inside corner. That is the first. Harker is the first Saluki to reach in 3 innings, snapping a streak of 9 consecutive. Batters retired, and now an offensive strategic huddle.
I want to make sure everybody's on the same page on that armband. Make sure they know what signals they're calling and make sure what's going on in this situation. You can't afford to have mistakes this late in the ballgame.
How many pages do you think are on that armband?
Well, there's got to be at least a dozen.
Big situation here. Loyola trying to advance to the semifinals as a 7 seed.
I don't know. Maybe they did see lightning. I'm not.
That's what I'm wondering.
Not sure if that's what the situation is.
Although they do monitor that here in the press box as well. It is not far from us.
No, it looks like it keeps sneaking up on us.
Probably about 25 miles to our west at the most. Good thing is it's moving northeast faster than it's moving east, so we might be able to get this one in. Here's the 0-1 pitch on the way from Ashton, a wave and a miss. So Ashton behind on the count, 0-2.
Gardner's done such a good job of when you do, or they do, get those runners on base. She starts to work ahead in the count. She wants the advantage on her side, and so she makes those good first pitches so she can be up in the count, put that hitter at a disadvantage.
One, two pitch. Fouled away.
Good job of plate coverage by Ashton going out, fouling off that pitch. Had to reach across a good part of the plate.
So the 1-2, and Ashton swings and I think got hit.
I don't know if it came up off the bat.
Couldn't tell, but she's obviously in some pain.
No, if she fouled it off, it popped up.
Oh.
Looks like it got her on the chin, maybe. Just right up under the face guard. And that hurts. That she got jammed, tried to pull the hands back, got a piece of the ball, popped straight up. And I do think that it got her right up underneath the jaw.
Yeah, that she's obviously in some pain, and understandably so.
You know, those face guards do a good job of protecting the hitter, and we've seen situations where the ball has come up and hit off that face mask, but it can only go so far, and that one got up underneath that face guard. Checking her over pretty good.
It's kind of a freak thing.
Yeah, they take all that protection, all that hardware to cover themselves up, and over the years through softball, we've seen the equipment get better and better as far as protection. There's just that one little gap where a ball could get, and that's exactly where it hit, right up underneath the chin.
So Kelsey Ashton still there in pain. Saluki trainer working on her.
And she might even be a little dizzy, too.
That's what you can have your bell rung. I mean, you tend to think of a blow straight to the head,
yeah.
But I mean, that's an uppercut to the jaw, is
exactly
what that is.
I think in prize fighting and boxing, and that ball comes right up where an uppercut might come if you're a boxer.
Right there.
Yep, right there, and that knocks her down right away.
Well, most importantly, we hope she's okay, but that's a big loss for Southern Illinois if, in fact, she's out for the game.
Right. You probably have to do some of those concussion tests on her to make sure that she's tracking and make sure, as you say, she didn't have her bell rung.
Brooke Womack will finish the at-bat, the count at 1-2. Talk about a difficult situation to come in and strike 3, the call. That's almost unfair.
Yeah, there's no other way to play it, but Womack been sitting on the bench and watching the game come in for one pitch, called third strike, and she goes back to the dugout.
And that'll bring Spivey to the plate. Spivey 0-2, runner at first. Spivey represents the tying run here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Brittany Gardner with 4 strikeouts in 4 2/3 innings of work. And the 1-0 from Gardner. In there for a strike.
Ivy needs to just get this ball in play, shorten up the swing a little bit, see if she can get herself on and get an opportunity to get a runner into scoring position.
This is outside, 2-1. Gardner has retired 11 of the last 12 Salukis. Here's the 2-1. Big changeup that time.
Just hung up there, didn't drop into the zone. That one just kind of hung right at about eye level. Didn't have much movement to it.
Hitter's count here for Spivey. Sees the tying run and the pitch. Struggling with it is Gardner. She recovers nicely, throws to first in time to get Spivey. So, a one-out hit goes for naught. We are through five. Loyola still with a two-run lead.
Help join a continent of nearly 3 million rugged square miles with a single broadband connection? When Emerson takes up the challenge, it's never been done before. Simply becomes, consider it solved. Emerson.
We've got a warm welcome waiting for you. And that is only the beginning. DoubleTree by Hilton, where the little things mean everything.
Top of the sixth inning on in what is now an official game. Today's date in MBC history brought to you by the St. Charles Convention and Visitors Bureau. May 8th, 1997, Southern Illinois edged UNI 4-3 in the first round of the MBC tournament at Birdsall Memorial Park in Cedar Falls. For your next trip to the Show Me State, go to historicstcharles.com or call 800-366-2427 to make your plans. Top of the sixth inning.
Now batting for Loyola, number 44, Jessica Balzano.
Jessica Balzano leads off and bunts. It's a beauty. Throw to first is not in time. May have been in time, but the throw handcuffed our new second baseman. Or that is Spivey out there. Sorry, it was Ashton that got hurt. That throw looked pretty good.
It did look very good, and I think maybe a little distraction with the runner, the ball, all arriving at the same time.
Hit down the right field line, and a nice play on the run by Patterson. So one gone.
Now batting for the Ramblers, number 13, Karen Safer.
Lauren Moore gave it a bit of a ride, but is retired. So Patterson with a nice play in right. This will bring Schaefer to the plate. Schaefer 0 for 1 with a sacrifice bunt.
Loyola sure would like another insurance run if they can move Balzano around.
Play was ruled an error on Spivey, the second baseman. Grounder to first, taking it unassisted is Orsberg. Two gone in the sixth. However, Balzano moves into scoring position.
Now batting for Loyola, number 15, Olivia Bell.
Olivia Bell stands in. Bell had the two-run double to put Loyola on top in the fourth inning. She has another opportunity to come through in the clutch. Bertelsen delivers on the outside corner.
This would be a huge run right here if Bell can deliver the base hit.
Swing and a miss, 0-2.
See, Bell took her head off of it, pulled her head out of there. Need to keep the head down, the eyes down. Nose right on the ball, watch it hit the bat.
1-2 pitch. She stays alive. Winner of this one will take on Illinois State in the second semifinal tomorrow afternoon. First semifinal is already set. It'll be 4-seed Bradley taking on regular season champion Wichita State. And the 1-2 swung on and missed. Loyola leaves the runner stranded. So we're now through 5.5. Loyola still with a 3-1 lead on Valley Live.
Word is getting out. Purina Dog Chow Light and Healthy is a deliciously tender and crunchy kibble blend with 20% fewer calories than Purina Dog Chow. Isn't it time you discovered the lighter side of Dog Chow? Purina Dog Chow Light and Healthy.
The online store at mvcgear.com is the number one stop to get Missouri Valley Conference merchandise. With thousands of items, you'll find all the MVC gear you need in one place. You'll find the best selection, great customer service, and secure order processing. You'll also get an easy and enjoyable experience designed to help you find exactly what you're looking for. So if you want the best place to get Missouri Valley Conference gear, head to the online store at mvcgear.com.
Who could resist the call of America's number one puppy food brand? With DHA and essential nutrients also found in mother's milk. Purina Puppy Chow.
Be sure to catch the title game of the Missouri Valley Conference Softball Tournament coming up Saturday, with the winner receiving the league's automatic bid to the NCAA Tournament. Remember, the game will not be seen here on Valley Live. Instead, coverage will begin at 2:30 Saturday at Central Time on Fox Sports Midwest, Fox Sports Indiana, Fox Sports Kansas City, Fox College Sports, Comcast Sportsnet Chicago, and ESPN3. Check your channel guide for more information. Time starting to run short for Southern Illinois.
Middle part of the lineup up for the Salukis, 4, 5, and 6. This is when they need to make some noise to climb back into this ballgame.
Shay Hari, a 331 hitter, leads off the inning, and Gardner delivers. Change up in there for a strike. Hari reached on an error in the first, struck out in the third. Gardner has not been dominating, but she's been steady today. Four strikeouts, three walks, five plus innings. Misses outside.
Sometimes that's all you need. You just need to, if you're not on top of your game, you just need to be steady and be efficient. Hit the spots when the occasion arises. Don't get yourself into too much trouble, and she has not done that at all here in this ball game. She has not put a whole lot of pressure on herself or the defense.
Murphy takes it unassisted. One gone. Kelsey Gonzalez next up against Gardner.
Now batting for Southern Illinois, number 7, Kelsey Gonzalez.
Gardner has now retired 12 of the last 13 Salukis. So the Valley Pitcher of the Year showing why. Push bunt. This will be a tough play. Did she tag her? The home plate umpire says no.
Going to get some argument from the Loyola dugout. It was close. It was bang, bang. It was a great bunt. Gonzalez hustles down the first baseline. See if we can pick it up. Drops it down the first baseline. I don't know if she got her. If she did, it was on the back end.
See if this angle is any better. It's tough to tell from the previous angle. I think the umpire made the right call.
And granted, the first base umpire is blocked by the play, asking for a little help from the home plate umpire, but...
So Gonzalez gets on with a bunt single. And it will bring Orsburn to the plate, representing the tying run here in the bottom of the sixth. And the pitch on the out, just off the corner. Horsburn batting 259, five homers.
Outfield playing at normal depth, but if a ball gets into the gap, that's definitely going to score a run.
Strike call. Gardner looks in at Schaefer, and the 1-1. Well outside. Gonzalez is the runner at first. She reached on the bunt up the first baseline. Orsburn trying to make something happen. She's ahead on the count, 2-1. And the pitch.
Gonzalez, five stolen bases and five attempts. Schaefer making sure she's keeping her close, bouncing out of that crouch behind the plate, ready to fire at any moment, but don't know if you'd take a chance at this point in time to try to steal.
3-1 pitch on the way. Swung on, hit well, deep left field, underneath it, making the catch is Court. Two gone. The wind that time pushing the ball toward the left fielder.
We've seen Korth a couple of times in this ball game just turn and head for the fence and then have to come in on the play, on the fly ball. And again, that one gets hung up in the wind, moved around a little bit, but Korth stayed right with it.
So with two gone and a runner still at first, Allie Badbunker stands in.
Now batting for the
She's hitting 229. She's flown out the center field twice in the ballgame. You may remember her last time up. She seemed to get a hold of one towards center field in the end and wound up going maybe higher than it did far. But at least off the bat, it sounded like good contact against Gardner.
Yeah, it sounded like it had home run distance on it, but again, just hung up there, and they were able to get a long out.
So the 1-0 pitch, in there for a strike. One pitch to Badbunker. Off the corner.
Both sides taking their time right now, and I know it's a tense situation. You got to know what every situation is, offensively, defensively, what you want to do.
Good cut by Badbunker.
Really was. I mean, she was right on it, fouled it straight back. Getting good plate coverage, able to get a piece of the bat on it.
Gonzalez the runner at first. Gardner looks in, and the 2-2 to Badbunker. Sailed 3-2. So
overthrew
the runner
that.
Will be going.
Overthrew that a little bit, got away from her, just got out of the zone, but now gives you an advantage with that runner starting over at first base on the pitch.
Three-two pitch on the way. Swung on and hit down the right field line. Just foul.
Well, Zworski playing deep over in right field. That ball was ticketed for a base hit. Zworski trying to get over there, but it falls harmlessly foul on the right field line.
Gonzalez was running on the full count, would have scored easily had that landed in fair territory. So we'll do the 3-2 again. And Gonzalez will be taking off again. So another 3-2. Back to Gardner. Toss the first in time, and the Salukis strand a runner. We are now through six. Loyola looking for the upset, leading 3-1.
Watch your Cardinals take the field from a whole new perspective this season. Introducing the AT&T Rooftop, located on the deck of Cardinals Nation at the new Ballpark Village. It's a unique way to enjoy a game in style. The AT&T Rooftop features more than 300 outdoor seats overlooking Busch Stadium, with amenities like an upscale buffet, a full-service bar, an exclusive indoor club, as well as complimentary admission to the Cardinals Hall of Fame and Museum. Visit Cardinals.com and get your AT&T Rooftop tickets today.
In the insurance business, you think differently about a customer when you stand in the middle of his dreams. When she serves you breakfast every Saturday morning. When his son plays on the same team as your son. When you live down the street from your customers, you make sure they get covered right. And you make sure you're there when they need you. That's the way it's done around here. Grinnell Mutual, a policy of working together. To find a Grinnell Mutual agent near you, go to GrinnellMutual.com.
7C Loyola looking to upend the Salukis as we head to the 7th. For all the latest news on the Missouri Valley Conference softball tournament, the upcoming MVC baseball tourney, as well as other Valley Spring sports, be sure to check out the official website of the Missouri Valley Conference, mvc-sports.com. Southern Illinois, get a look at Michelle Glenn in left field. Salukis have to hold Loyola here.
They need to try to make quick work of Loyola. See if they can get themselves back up at bat in a quick fashion.
Bertelson facing Annie Korth. And the count even at a ball and a strike. Line for Bertelson, six innings, three hits, three runs, all earned, four strikeouts, and a walk. Gave up the home run in the first inning to Lauren Moore. The other big blow, Olivia Bell's two-run double. That's the difference in the game. That came in the fourth inning. Count even at 2-2.
Well, she's really, other than those two big hits, done a pretty good job being in and around the zone. Defense has picked her up nicely, made some nice plays.
Hit toward the gap in right center field. That will likely be a double. Going in, standing up is Korth. So Loyola looking for a little insurance against Katie Bertelson.
Now they're in business. They've got that runner in scoring position. Nobody out. Going to be a meeting in the circle. Korth went right with that pitch. Took it to right center field, right in the gap, all the way up to the fence.
Barry Blaylock, the head coach for the Salukis. Blaylock in her 15th season.
That meeting was very short and to the point, basically saying, strand that runner on second base. We can't afford to give up another run.
Now batting for
Lauren Zaworski. Stands in, rips one down the line. I thought she flinched a little bit. I thought she might square around.
I did
get
too.
Get the runner over to third.
Why not? You'd rather have that runner at third base, two opportunities to knock him in, but why not? Now you have three opportunities. Base hit probably would score. I think you might gamble a little bit and send that runner.
Now she bunts through at 0-2. So Zaworski was given one chance to swing away. Had one chance for the sacrifice. Now she's going to have to swing away again. Fouls it off her forearm.
You'd like to see her move it to the right side if she can. If she can wait back a little bit, put the ball in play the right side, that would also move the runner up to third base.
Bertelsen delivers the 1-2 in the dirt.
Good job by Vadbunker to keep the ball in front. Sometimes you lose sight of those, and that allows that runner to move up.
2-2 pitch. She stays alive. It'll be the 8, 9, and 1 slots for Southern Illinois in the bottom of the 7th.
Definitely doing that tonight.
So Patterson, Glenn, and Harker. Two-two on the way. Fouled up, right side, and out of play.
You know, a good battle. Swirsky doing everything she can to try to move that runner or get a base hit. Burleson up to the task as well, making some good pitches.
And the pitch, lace just foul.
Well, they wanted a fastball in, and they got a fastball in, but Swirsky knew it as well, turned on it, pulled it foul.
Two-two. Ripped. That is a fair ball, and it'll drive in a run. Korth scores. Zaworski with an RBI double. It's a three-run Loyola lead.
Credit Zaworski for that at bat. She fouled off a lot of pitches and then got one out over the plate, turned on it just off the glove of Womack, hugs the line, goes all the way to the fence.
So an RBI double, this one is shallow right, and it'll fall in for a base hit. Moving on to third is Zaworski, and Murphy has a base hit. And Loyola in a position to blow this one open.
That ball just over the infield, but not far enough to get to the outfielders, kind of in no man's land out there, drops in for the base hit, and runners now at the corners. Nobody out.
Katie Lasavita, 0-2 in this one, stands in. And still nobody out, as you mentioned. Hits it a long way foul.
They're getting some good hacks at her now. They're starting to time everything, get that confidence level up. They're going up there being very aggressive, swinging away on the first pitch.
The 0-1. This one is smacked into right center field. That'll drive home a run. Murphy on her way to third. She'll stop there, and pulling up with a double is La Savita. It's 5-1 Ramblers.
You could just tell by her presence at the plate. She felt very comfortable with a couple of the pitches she fouled off. Goes down and gets that one. Drives it into the gap, and she's standing on second base.
Katie Bertelsen really laboring for Southern Illinois. Still nobody out. And Bree Pasquale
now batting for the Ramblers, number seven,
stands in. The shortstop looks at a strike on the inside corner.
Breaking it wide open here in the top of the seventh inning. Came up to the plate feeling very relaxed, very confident. Start the inning off, fourth with a double, backed up with another double and base hit, and then the third double of the inning.
0-2 the count to Pasquale. 0-3 in this one. Led off the Drake game with a home run. She has 5 on the year.
So this Loyola team, not just one hitter that's doing it. It's all up and down the lineup.
Line to left and too shallow for the runner Murphy to make an attempt. The ball well struck, but Pasquale flies out to left. That's the first out of the inning. And Jessica Balzano stands in. Van Bunker with another good stop. Balzano one for three, a double and a run scored, and she might drive in two here. Definitely drives in one. Murphy scores. La Civita holds at third. It's an RBI single for Balzano.
Well, what have we said a couple of times today, that hitting is contagious? In the top of the seventh inning, they lead off with a double. Everybody behind is getting good looks at Bertelsen, making good contact, and they're starting to run away and hide.
And with runners at first and third, still just one out, Lauren Moore stands in. She's already homered tonight. A homer and a walk. She scored twice. Loyola now the seventh seed with a 6-1 lead. One and one the count.
Boy, if she gets a hold of one here, this certainly will be the final nail, I think. You know, you always like to get one insurance run. Three insurance runs are great.
Grounder to short. Throw to first is in time. La Civita had to hold at third. Balzano moves to second as Moore is retired. 6-3. Two gone. Schaefer stands in with two outs, but still two runners in scoring position. Three already in the inning for the Ramblers. Trying to move on to the semifinals as a 7 seed. Bertelsen pitches. Spins it back to Bertelsen, and the side is finally retired, but three insurance runs for Loyola. We head to the bottom of the 7th with the Ramblers leading 6-1.
You could fly to Venice or Paris or even Copenhagen. You could fly all over the world. But why? When you could just come to St. Louis. Your trip begins at ExploreSt.Louis.com.
Life has its twists and turns. It can take many different shapes. But a good retirement plan changes with your life. And as we talk about what you're putting away and how much you'll need to retire, what was uncertain becomes clear. At Wells Fargo Advisors, we believe conversation leads to financial clarity. Let's start a conversation today.
The 2014 Missouri Valley Conference Softball Tournament is brought to you by Coventry Healthcare and Aetna Company, the official presenting sponsor for the MVC TV network. By Emerson, the global technology and engineering company, Emerson Considered Solved. And by Casey's General Store, Casey's, famous for pizza. Bottom of the seventh inning, last chance for third seed Southern Illinois. It'll be 8-9-1. Patterson, Glenn, and Harker up for the Salukis. Loyola coming into the tournament with a 22-30 overall record, 11-15 in the Valley, trying to upset Southern Illinois and move on to play host Illinois State in our second game tomorrow. Three outs to go, however. Gardner, the Valley Pitcher of the Year, in the circle for Loyola. And the first pitch is low it in to Patterson.
And off speed again. And I'd like to go back and look at the two games that Loyola has played, see how many times that Gardner has started off a hitter with that off speed pitch.
2-0. A little surprising to see Gardner, I think, fall behind 2-0 with a 5-run lead.
Well, sometimes you know you have that big cushion.
That's
you might not
strike.
Be as focused as you are when it's a 2-run cushion.
Sure.
And so maybe you lose a little bit of your edge when you know you have the game in hand.
So Gardner's 2-1. On the corner, 2-2. Patterson 1-for-2. Singled back in the second inning. 2-2 on the way. Change up. She held off.
Doing a good job of working the count. They need base runners. They need lots of base runners at this point. We talked a little bit about Southern Illinois, that they have been able to get themselves on base either via the walk, hit by pitch, and there's one to start the inning for them.
So Patterson coaxes a walk to lead off the inning, and this is going to result in a trip by Schaefer to the circle. Moore joins her from third base.
Just an opportunity to talk to one another and say, you know what, we don't care about that runner over there on first base. We've got the 5-run lead. Let's just get outs. Let's think outs.
Pinch hitter into the game for Glenn. This is Meredith Wilson. Fouls it back to the screen. Wilson, a 277 hitter, 3 homers on the season. She's driven in 20 runs. She's a junior from Granite City, Illinois. And the 0-1, just off the corner. One-one, a little bit low, 2-1. I'll say it again, yeah. It's a little surprising to see Gardner with a 5-run lead just not go right after him.
Yeah, she's been very efficient, been nibbling at the corners, getting the call. Now she's backed off a little bit on the speed and trying to be a little bit too good with her pitches. She just needs to come after these hitters.
3-1.
Moore kind of directing traffic out there in the infield. Talking to her teammates, trying to settle down Gardner.
3-1 pitch to Wilson. 3-2 the count now. This would be a big win for Loyola, not just because you advance to the semifinals, but to win two games in one day as a seventh seed, and to do so in your first year in a new conference. This will be a tough play, but what a play by Moore. The runner from first, Patterson, will advance. And alertly, a lot of Ramblers scramble to cover third.
What a great job by Moore, going away with her back to the infield, over the shoulder catch, and then turns and fires as she sees Patterson tagging up at first.
Loyola appealed, saying that Patterson left early, nothing doing. So runner at second, with one gone. Top of the order now for Kaylin Harker. And the 0-1 pitch, wave and a miss.
That one sounded like it had a little purpose to it. That one had a little speed, and Harker just could not catch up to it. Ran up right through it.
The 0-1. Count even at a ball and a strike. Again, be sure to join us tomorrow on Valley Live at noon Central. Four-seeded Bradley takes on top seed Wichita State. Then at 2:30, second seed Illinois State plays the winner of this one.
Was it a lefty slap hitter and that ball hangs up there like that? That's the one that you want to take advantage of.
2-1 the count. Patterson the runner at second. And the 2-1. Swing and a miss. We're even at 2-2. Gardner delivers the 2-2. Swing and a miss. Two gone here in the seventh inning. Five strikeouts now for Brittany Gardner.
A lot of enthusiasm after that one, knowing how close they are to moving into the semifinal game.
And the final hope for the Salukis, Brooke Womack, who came in for Kelsey Ashton after Ashton fouled the ball off of her chin. Womack came in. That foul made the count 1-2 on Ashton, and Womack just looked at one pitch. It was a strike call in the outside corner. And that was the end of the at-bat. 1-0. The Ramblers an out away from moving to the semis. 2-0.
You got to forget about any runner that's on base and make this be your third out here at the plate.
2-0 pitch. Good movement. Caught the inside corner. 2-1 the count. Loyola with a run in the first, two more in the fourth, and then three here in the top of the seventh. The Saluki run came in the bottom of the first.
Yeah, they were able to answer right away, gave up the home run in the top half of the inning, came back with a run of their own, and then could not match the two spot put up in the fifth in the fourth inning. So, and from that point, Loyola took command.
3-1 now the count. And again, Schaefer will head out and talk to Gardner. Gardner looking for her second complete game victory on the day. Ball four. So Womack draws a two-out walk. Spivey will come to the plate. Southern Illinois just trying to keep the game alive.
Gotta like that at bat for Womack. Really only saw one pitch in her last at bat. As she finished it up for Ashton. Does a good job of battling at the plate. Now two runners on, still alive. There's still some hope for Southern Illinois.
Change up, little high, 1-0. Gardner today, 13 2/3 innings pitched. He's given up seven hits and struck out 14 while giving up just one run. Grounder to second. Throw to first is in time. And Loyola, the seventh seed, upsets Southern Illinois And the Ramblers will move to tomorrow's semifinal game against second-seeded Illinois State. Our players of the game, a presentation of Coventry Healthcare and Aetna Company. Visit CoventryHealthcare.com for more information. Health, wellness, Coventry Healthcare. And despite the outstanding offensive performance by Loyola, player of the game for the Ramblers, probably a pretty easy selection.
Well, yeah, Gardner doing a good job for Loyola. Two games, complete games. Did everything she needed to do for her team to get them into the semis.
For the Salukis, we're going to go with Gina Spivey. Spivey having put together such a great season, a senior. And she sees her career come to an end with the loss today. Our play of the game is presented by Worth Sports, the official softball of the Missouri Valley Conference. Worth Sports, legit power, legit performance. And the big double off the bat of Olivia Bell put Loyola out in front for good. Two RBI double at that time, giving Loyola a 3-1 lead. So Olivia Bell with our play of the game. Loyola upset Southern Illinois. Back with more after this on Valley Live.
You want affordable health care coverage that helps cover rising medical costs. And that's exactly what you'll get with Coventry. We offer a variety of affordable plans for you, your family, or business. To find out more, visit CoventryHealthcare.com today. Health, wellness, Coventry.
It's a star-struck summer at Casey's General Stores. Visit Casey's for spectacular spotlight savings, like Powerade 32-ounce bottles, 3 for $3, and large made-from-scratch taco pizzas for only $13.99. Plus, discover the secret word and enter to win a fabulous trip for two to Hollywood, $500 in gas, or other amazing prizes. Now premiering at Casey's General Stores. Casey's, famous for pizza.
Sorry.
Oh, hey, and check out that new look from Pepsi.
I don't know why, but today I feel a little bit different.
Oh, I feel like a woke this morning. I can change the world. I can change the world. I get the truth.
You want affordable healthcare coverage that helps cover rising medical costs. And that's exactly what you'll get with Coventry. We offer a variety of affordable plans for you, your family, or business. To find out more, visit CoventryHealthcare.com today. Health, wellness, Coventry.
Seven-seeded Loyola upsets Southern Illinois in our final on this Thursday at the Missouri Valley Conference Softball Tournament in Normal, Illinois. Be sure to join us at noon tomorrow. Now, weather could be an issue here in central Illinois tomorrow. So if there are any changes, they'll be posted immediately to MVCSports.com. So check out the website. But as of now, we are sticking with our schedule. Noon central tomorrow is top seed and Missouri Valley Conference regular season champion Wichita State plays four-seeded Bradley in our first semifinal contest. Then at 2:30 central, the matchup features second seed Illinois State and seventh seeded Loyola. Again, if there are any changes due to weather, we will post those immediately on MVC-sports.com. For Laura Leonard and our entire Webstream Sports crew, I'm RC McBride. Thanks for joining us on Valley Live.